When Martin Heidegger was asked for some useful advice, he said, spend more time in graveyards. Spend more time in graveyards. It reminds me of what Pascal believed, that most of the pathologies of mankind results from this derivative of not being able to sit alone in a room with his own thoughts, and that's where our pathologies come from. That kind of echoes the sentiment of a Hebrew philosopher. It's better to spend time at funerals than it is to spend time at parties. But Heidegger also proposed another way of being awakened to the strangeness of our being, and that is, and this is something I like far more, that is going on a walk in the countryside. Like, he liked to pick mushrooms, he liked to go to bed early, he didn't like the big city, he didn't like the chatter, you know, the chatter of the media? Like, he liked to be apart from all of that and to contemplate the strangeness of being, because we're all trying to avoid the nothing, the nothing, right? And I don't think you have to go to a funeral to do that. I think you can go in a countryside and do that. Like, I was at a waterfall today, cold plunging with some friends, and I'm like, the strangeness of the thing is overwhelming. Like, I'm overwrought with this overwhelming sense of strangeness. In the best sense of the word, in the beautiful sense of the word. And we have to confront this, because Heidegger talked about our thrownness, that we are thrown into certain prejudices, we are thrown into a certain chronological historical time frame. Ontologically, we have no say in when we're born. Like, we can't choose the time we're born, we can't choose the place we're born, we can't choose the people to whom we were born. Like, unless you believe in prenatal existence or sort of reincarnation, we have no say in the matter, right? Unless you're with Plato and that kind of stuff. But I'm saying you are thrown into this chaos. And so you can see why he was an existentialist. But I actually believe something different. I don't believe that caprice and fortuity run the order of the day, because it's all up for grabs when you're talking about this stuff. I believe the inventor of the initial singularity has an expansive plan for the galaxies, and that includes the chronology and significance of our own biographical ontological lives. And so when we contemplate the strangeness of the waterfall, when we go in a walk in the countryside, or like Heidegger, he would go pick mushrooms, didn't like the big cities, didn't like to listen to the chatter. Like, I want to be somebody who's constantly awakened to the strangeness of the thing and can overwhelm the nothingness by being overwrought and overwhelmed by my own being and by the being of all things and the fact that we're all interconnected. And that's something the School of Life talks about as well. But I find like great comfort in this reality, that I don't have to just go to a funeral. Like, I can't tell you the last time I've been to a funeral, it's been years. I want to go to nature, and that awakens me to something so much more grand, right? It awakens me to being with a capital B. It awakens me to value theory, aesthetics, beauty with a capital B, the ideal of the thing. So can I encourage you, take a walk in the countryside. Like, when I was cold plunging in the waterfall today, I was awakened to the strangeness of the thing. When's the last time you were awakened to the strangeness of your own being? And that will cause you to put out the chatter, to live authentically, and to stop trying to please people who never really liked you in the first place. And instead, you can live a life that is of significance, a life that matters, where you create your own value structure.